Do you have a piece of wooden furniture lying around that's too damaged to use? Or have you ever seen one on the side of the road that's too beat up to be brought home? Hi friends, I'm Jamie from SoMuchBetterWithAge.com and I'm dedicated to helping you create a beautiful life with easy to follow DIY projects, home decorating, organization, and a little bit of life advice along the way. In today's video, I'm gonna show you 8 techniques on how to repair badly damaged wooden furniture like this one. All of these techniques I'm about to explain to you are for painting furniture. So they're ways that you could salvage furniture and then paint over it afterwards. For the first technique, you might have a piece of furniture that has damaged veneer. The whole top of this dresser was so badly damaged. It was coming off in chunks and it was sitting on the side of the road because nobody thought it could be salvaged. Well, I have some wood filler and a putty knife, and that will solve all your problems with the veneer coming off. You do have to go over it multiple times, but when you fill in all the holes and gaps with your putty and sand it down, and you might have to repeat it a couple times, it'll have a smooth finish that's easy to paint. For technique 2, for wood that's splitting or broken off, wood glue is your best bet. There was some splitting wood on this edge of this dresser here, and I used some glue and a clamp, and when I put the glue in there and press this down overnight, you can easily sand it down and paint over it, and you had no idea that there was a crack there. If you have parts of drawers that are falling apart, there's so many different size clamps on the market. You can put some glue where the crack is and clamp it with these and set it overnight. Technique 3, missing hardware. There's so many places to buy hardware online nowadays, but if you want to keep the original hardware that it came with, and it's maybe only missing one or two pieces, you can do what I've done and add two different handles or knobs to maybe just the top part of the dresser, and you can still make it look consistent. It was hard to find replicates of these handles, so I put other knobs on top. So technique 4 is when drawer guides have fallen off. These pieces here sometimes are wobbly, they have completely fallen off, and most times people think that they're completely unsalvageable. But if you get some wood glue and a clamp, maybe a few brad nails or finishing nails, depending on how your piece of furniture is put together, you can easily fix it by making sure it's aligned straight so that the drawer will easily go back in. Technique 5 is completely missing drawer guides, like on the backs of these. These guides need to go in between the ones here, and sometimes these are completely missing from your drawers. You will not be able to find replacements like this online. You'll have to make your own. And what they have now are little plastic guides, and they don't normally fit for these old pieces of furniture. So what I have done is taken these off another drawer, cut them in half, because you really only need half of it for the guide to work. So if you see drawers that don't have any guides in the back, not to worry. As long as you have at least one, you're good to make more with them. Technique 6 is a bad finish. Sometimes the piece of furniture is wood, but it's really shiny, really glossy. Taking the sheen off with a little bit of sanding, just by hand, all over it, along with some primer and paint, will make this dresser completely brand new. Technique 7, old hardware. If you want to refinish the old hardware and you don't want to paint it, you can easily put a product called Rub and Buff on it to give it a different sheen. If there is paint on it and you want to take the paint off, you can put it in an old crock pot and set it overnight so that the paint comes off. You can still keep the old hardware and restore it. Technique 8 is when a whole piece of furniture is falling apart. I had this piece of furniture and it looks like it was completely unsalvageable again. And with buckets of wood putty and bins of refinishing nails, I was able to put it all together again. You're basically going to be using a combination of all these things, but it is possible. This piece that I had used so much wood putty and tons of little finishing nails, and that's all that was needed. Once it was all put together, it was so easy to paint. One of the feet was missing, so I took it off and it just sat flat on the ground. These are just some of the ways that I have taken old pieces of furniture and saved them from the landfill. I love wooden furniture for the strength of it. They become a great strong piece in your house. You can repaint it over and over again. Once you've practiced these tips, you'll become your own little expert. You'll be finding pieces of furniture on the side of the road and making things up and fixing them up. People won't have any idea what it looked like before. I know you'll be inspired to try this yourself and to try these techniques on your pieces of furniture you find on the side of the road or in the thrift store. For more inspiration, be sure to check out my other DIY videos. Make sure to comment, like, and subscribe, and thanks for watching.